your journey. You come from the streets of Cincinnati, as your promoter said, and now you're fighting on pay-per-view against quote-unquote fighter of the decade. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say quote-unquote, but fighter of the decade.
It's just a dream come true, you know, and I'm just here to show the younger talent, the younger guys in Cincinnati and around the world that come from poverty and the type of places I come up, you know, that just follow your dream and work hard and you can make it too.
What's the toughest battle you've had in life?
The toughest battle I had in life?
Sure.
I tried surfing once.
On land. Huh. Hardest, toughest battle on land.
Oh.
On land? honestly?
Yes.
I can't say.
Okay. This is not the second half of your career, but you're 29. What impression do you want to leave on boxing? Because the next stage is obviously 100% promotion, encouraging the kids in Cincinnati. What's?
I just want to leave the boxing world entertained, and I just want to be the best Adrian Bronner I can be, you know. And when you bring up Adrian Bronner, you know, it always brings a smile to somebody's face and make somebody day better, and they can learn from me.
Go ahead, Michelle. Ladies first.
We've seen Manny Pacquiao be knocked out before. Do you feel that you can do the same, Jerry?
Of course. He's been knocked out before, and there's no mystery he'll go to sleep again.
There are a slew of great 147-pounders that are undefeated, and you will be the first 147-pound outside of Floyd Mayweather. What's the secret to becoming a pay-per-view star in this market? Well, Terrence Crawford, but it didn't do well. I'm sorry.
It's more than just being a boxer. You have to be an entertainer. You know, it's entertainment, and you got to make people want to watch you, no matter if they want to see you lose or want to see you win. And I think I kind of got that down back.